Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am Dr. Ibram Sadiq and I am working as assistant professor in Department of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences, Faisalabad Medical University. Today I will discuss with you people about what is learning, what is learning theory basically, and the types of its types, and how we can use and how we can shape our behavior by using this kind of learning theory. Learning is the process by which new behavior patterns are acquired. This is a key process in human behavior. It plays a central role in our language, customs, personality, traits, and even our perceptions. Humans have instinctual patterns similar to those of animals, but their complex behavior patterns are a result of their advanced learning capacity. Learning is a relatively permanent change in behavior for better or worse. So, there are two types of conditioning: operant conditioning and classical conditioning. First, we will discuss what is operant conditioning and how you can use operant conditioning in your day-to-day activities. And second, we will discuss later about classical conditioning. Learning theory implies that learning new behaviors or change in behavior occurs on the basis of the environmental condition or responses to it. This is known as operant conditioning or instrumental conditioning. Operant conditioning was established by work of B.F. Skinner. Operant conditioning occurs when a behavior that is not a part of person's natural responses is learned or unlearned by consequences for the individual in the form of reward or punishment. Operant conditioning explains the learning of voluntarily behaviors such as motor actions. The famous box, Skinner box, demonstrated operant conditioning by placing a rat in a box in which the pressing of a small lever produces food. Skinner showed that the rat eventually learns to press the bar regularly to obtain food. If, however, rat pressed the lever and received an electric shock or nothing at all, like punishment or lack of reinforcement, it stopped pressing the lever. Skinner's work showed that operant conditioning works on the principles of reinforcement. Reinforcement refers to any event that increases the chance that a response will occur again or a behavior will be repeated. So there are three types of reinforcement: positive reinforcement, negative reinforcement, and punishment. So what is positive reinforcement? Positive reinforcement is when one receives a reward for a behavior, which results in the behavior being reinforced and thus repeated. This reward may be in the form of attention, praise, success, and material gain. So positive reinforcement is when you adding a positive cheese, as when you adding a thing like a reward for learning a behavior, and when you consistently giving that reward to that person will learn ultimate behavior. An example is a child who consistently gets a praise or hug for picking up his toys after playing with them will learn to be neat and orderly. जैसे हम बच्चों को अपने जो है उनको गाइड करते हैं कि आप अगर ये इतने मार्क्स अटेन करेंगे तो ये आपको इनाम दिया जाएगा. बच्चा फिर कोशिश करता है उतने मार्क्स की, उसको हम गुड देते हैं, उसको प्रेज करते हैं, उसको कोई गिफ्ट हम रखते हैं. तो इसी तरह आपने जब कोई छोटे बिहेवियर्स ऐसे लर्न करवाने हो तो जो पॉजिटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट है दैट वुड हेल्पफुल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रेज और अटेंशन और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इवन रिवॉर्ड. तो इसमें हमेशा आप पॉजिटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट में रिवॉर्ड ऐड करते हो और न्यू बिहेवियर लर्न करते हो. And punishment is when a behavior is followed by a painful stimulus, resulting in the behavior being stopped and not repeated. If a child puts her finger into an electric socket and gets electrocuted, she is not likely to do it again. अब नेगेटिव रिइंफोर्समेंट क्या है? दिस इज नॉट द सेम एज पॉजिटिव एज पनिशमेंट. इन नेगेटिव रिइंफोर्समेंट इज व्हेन अ नेगेटिव स्टिमुलस इज स्टॉप्ड ओनली व्हेन अ डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर अकर. दिस इज एक्सपीरियंस्ड कॉमनली एज अ पर्सन इन कार आउट ऑफ द वे. इन दिस केस द नॉइज ऑफ द लाउड हॉर्न इज द नेगेटिव स्टिमुलस. द डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर इज मूविंग द कार. इसमें आप एक जो स्टिमुलस है पॉजिटिव में आप रिवॉर्ड की शक्ल में ऐड कर रहे हो, नेगेटिव में आप एक नेगेटिव स्टिमुलस ऐड कर रहे हो ताकि डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर को लर्न किया जा सके. लाइक द लिवर बॉक्स एक्सपेरिमेंट बाय स्किनर मेंशन्ड अबव प्रूव दैट अ बिहेवियर will occur more frequently if given positive reinforcement and will decrease in frequency by punishment. Like there is a scenario in your books in which the mother came with a child who wet his bed even when he is 10 years old, 7 years old I think, and as a treatment the psychiatrist add a reward to the person that if he will try his bed then he will get the reward, and second was instrument bell was established with his bladder so that whenever there is urine came into the bladder the buzzer will master A describing the beginning of the section was instrumentally conditioned to remain dry by the use of buzzer. The reward that he got in the form of a chocolate was a positive reinforcement, whereas the act of the getting up and washing his clothes was a negative reinforcement. उसमें हमने क्या किया था कि हमने जब भी वो यूरिन पास कर देता था तो उसको कहा जाता था कि वो अपने उठ के खुद चेंज करे और खुद शीट को भी चेंज करे, उसे वॉश करे. दैट वाज अ नेगेटिव रिइंफोर्समेंट. ये भी शेप करेगी उसके बिहेवियर को. इसी तरह अगर उसको थोड़ा साइकोलॉजिकली अगर हम डील करते हैं और उसे हम रिवॉर्ड के तौर पर चॉकलेट्स या कोई भी उसकी फेवरेट चीज देते हैं एंड आस्क हिम that when he will remain dry at the night we will give that reinforcement to the child, so that will act as a positive reinforcement. The various types of reinforcement and punishments are summarized in the table below. We will discuss all these types of reinforcement and punishments in the table form later. An important consideration in changing and manipulating behavior is the relative effectiveness of the various types of reinforcement. Positive reinforcement is the most effective method in changing behavior, while punishment is the worst. This is why you may notice that a person has to be punished many times before his or her undesired behavior is stopped. Another factor to keep in mind with children is their need for attention, which acts as positive reinforcement, even if the attention involves being yelling at or punished. A child who is repeatedly scolded for nail biting or thumb sucking may persist with these habits beyond childhood. So, attention is a form of reinforcement, either in the positive way when you are attending the child or in the negative way when you are yelling at the child, shouting at the child or scolding him. That will not help. So, there is you can see there is the type of apparent conditioning, that is reinforcement, that then is punishment. In reinforcement, what you want to increase the behavior, while in punishment, you want to decrease the behavior. So, when you reinforce that in the way of positive or negative, in negative, you have to adding any stimulus for the correct behavior, while in negative reinforcement either you remove the noxious stimulus or your behavior avoids noxious stimulus, like active avoidance. You do active avoidance. In escape there is removal of the noxious stimulus. Like जैसे कि आपने वो रैट वाले एक्सपेरिमेंट में देखा कि उन्होंने जब उसके साथ अलार्म क्लॉक भी अटैच कर दिया तो वो एक बेल बजने से नेगेटिव स्टिमुलस आ जाता था. इसी तरह एक्टिव अवॉइडेंस में क्या है कि बिहेवियर अवॉइड्स नॉक्सियस स्टिमुलस, स्टडिंग टू अवॉइड गेटिंग अ बैड ग्रेड. अगर हम इस डर से पढ़ते हैं तो वो एक्टिव अवॉइडेंस है कि हमारे कहीं सप्लीन आ जाए, दैट इज एक्टिव अवॉइडेंस. सॉरी. एंड वाइल इन पनिशमेंट द अल्टीमेट डिजायर इज टू डिक्रीज द बिहेवियर आइदर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पॉजिटिव और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नेगेटिव. पॉजिटिव में क्या है जी, एड नॉक्सियस स्टिमुलस, जैसे कि हम स्लैप करते हैं, स्कोल्ड किया बहुत या कोई पनिशमेंट दे दी उसको चाइल्ड को कि आपने ये करना है उसके बिहेवियर को स्टॉप करने के लिए. व्हाइल इन नेगेटिव पनिशमेंट वी रिमूव एपिटेटिव स्टिमुलस फॉलोइंग बिहेवियर, हम उसका जो स्टिमुलस है उसको रिमूव कर देते हैं सो दैट द बिहेवियर कुड डिक्रीज. This table is also available in your books, which is showing the different types of reinforcement and punishment. You can see what is positive reinforcement. So you can see positive reinforcement behavior is increased by reward. उसमें क्या example है कि तारीफ हासिल करने के लिए बच्चा अपने छोटे भाई की तरफ बहुत ज्यादा kind हो गया. This is an example के praise क्या है ये हमने add किया उसमें. So reward or reinforcement increases desired behavior. नेगेटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट में क्या है, बिहेवियर इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय अवॉइडिंग और एस्केप. लाइक डांट से बचने के लिए वो अपने छोटे भाई के साथ ज्यादा काइंड है टू अवॉइड गेटिंग स्कोल्डेड, कि उसको डांट पड़ेगी या मार पड़ेगी तो वो अपने भाई. तो क्या अल्टीमेट डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर हमारा क्या है कि आप अपने बच्चा जो है वो अपने भाई के साथ ज्यादा काइंड रहे, उसके साथ नाइस रहे. तो उसमें नेगेटिव रिइंफोर्समेंट में वो अवॉइड करने के लिए. सो एक्टिव अवॉइडेंस ऑफ एन एवर्सिव स्टिमुलस इंक्रीज डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर. नाउ वी सी व्हाट इज पनिशमेंट. पनिशमेंट बिहेवियर इज डिक्रीज्ड बाय सुप्रेशन. सो चाइल्ड डिक्रीजेस हिज हिटिंग बिहेवियर व्हेन हिज मदर स्कोल्ड्स हिम. जब माँ ने डांटा जोर से तो उसने स्टॉप कर दिया. जैसे हम सडनली स्लैप कर देते हैं बच्चों को और उनका बिहेवियर वहीं पे स्टॉप हो जाता है. सो डिलीवरी ऑफ एन एवर्सिव स्टिमुलस डिक्रीजेस अनवांटेड बिहेवियर. ठीक है. एंड व्हाट इज एक्सटिंक्शन. एक्सटिंक्शन इज बिहेवियर इज एलिमिनेटेड बाय नॉन रीइंफोर्समेंट. नॉन रीइंफोर्समेंट क्या होती है कि आपने ना पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव तवज्जो ही नहीं दी बिल्कुल. एंड चाइल्ड स्टॉप्स हिज हिटिंग बिहेवियर व्हेन द बिहेवियर इज इग्नोर्ड बाय द मदर. इग्नोर करने का मतलब है कि मदर वहां पे अवेलेबल ही नहीं है, ना वो पॉजिटिव तवज्जो दे रही है कि उसको मना करे जा रही है, ना वो नेगेटिव दे रही है कि उसको डांट रही है. सो एक्सटेंशन इज मोर इफेक्टिव देन पनिशमेंट फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म रिडक्शन इन अनवांटेड बिहेवियर. यूजुअली वी रिकमेंड इन चिल्ड्रन एक्सटेंशन कि जैसे अगर बच्चा कोई ऐसा बिहेवियर या जिद कर रहा है और आप उसको डांट देती हैं तो भी उसका रीइंफोर्स होता है बिहेवियर. अगर आप उसको बहुत ज्यादा उस टाइम पे अटेंशन देती हैं देन बिहेवियर इज ऑल्सो रीइंफोर्सिंग. सो एक्सटेंशन इज नॉन रीइंफोर्समेंट के नाम ने पॉजिटिव तवज्जो देनी है ना नेगेटिव देनी है. तो इग्नोर कर देंगी तो बच्चे का बिहेवियर अल्टीमेटली खत्म हो जाएगा. सो वी विल डिस्कस द सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ कंडीशनिंग विच इज क्लासिकल कंडीशनिंग. It is another principle of the learning theory. It involves three factors: a natural stimulus, a stimulus that causes a biological response, and the biological response itself. So basically in operant conditioning we can learn the behavior by adding or decreasing the enforcement, while in classical conditioning we change the stimulus. And we need here we need a stimulus which can produce the biological response. It is a form of learning that occurs when these two stimuli are paired. Then natural stimulus is known as the conditioned stimulus. This is usually a neutral object such as a bell, a picture or a smell. The other condition is known as unconditioned stimulus. The unconditioned stimulus is one that is inherently capable of producing a biological response such as food or increased room temperature. The biological response is known as the unconditioned response. Salivation, pyloerection, sweating, and autonomic arousal are types of biological response. When biological response is elicited with a stimulus that causes it, such as food causing salivation, this is known as unconditioned response. When a biological response is coupled with a stimulus that would not normally cause it, such as a bell causing salivation, this is known as conditioned response. So the main difference between classical conditioning and operant conditioning is stimulus is provided before reflex, while in operant stimulus is provided after reflex. It is developed by Russian scientist Pavlov, while operant conditioning is developed by US scientist Skinner. It relies on association between stimulus and response, while operant conditioning relies on reinforcement. While in classical conditioning, the response is biological. It's involuntary or automatic. While in operant conditioning, and the voluntary response is needed. While it's a passive learning, while operant conditioning is active learning. So we will see Ivan Pavlov, a Russian physiologist, in 1890s established many of the basic principles of classical conditioning. He designed an apparatus that could measure the amount of saliva being produced in the dog's mouth in response to food, that is unconditioned response. Then Pavlov noted that no saliva flowed when he rang a bell. He then trained the dog by sounding the bell and then shortly afterwards presenting food. अब उसने क्या किया कि unconditioned stimulus को conditioned कर दिया, bell को conditioned कर दिया साथ में. After the sound of the bell has been paired with food a new times, that he tested the effect of training by measuring the amounts of saliva. When he rang by measuring the amount of saliva, when he rang the bell but did not present food, he discovered that some saliva was produced in response to the sound of bell, conditioned stimulus alone. So this is conditioned response. Similarly, people in many parts of the world have learned to associate the golden letter McDonald's M with tasty fast food and developed a conditioned response. बिग मैक की स्मेल से मुंह में पानी आ जाता है, कुछ अच्छे फूड से एम को देखते ही बच्चे स्टार्ट कर देते हैं. सो ये कंडीशन कर रहते हैं हम अपने रिस्पॉन्स को. सो एक्सटेंशन इज द प्रोसेस बाय विच कंडीशन्ड रिस्पॉन्स डिक्रीजेज इफ द कंडीशन्ड स्टिमुलस इज नेवर अगेन पेयर्ड with the unconditioned stimulus. For example, if only bell is rung but no food is presented, the salivation in response to the ringing of bell will eventually stop, that is become extinct. Pavlov ne jab bell akeli rung karni tab bhi jo hai na saliva collect ho jata tha, but agar hum food present nahi karenge aur bell rung karte jayenge to at the end saliva present nahi hoga, wo extinct kar jayega. So the other form of learning are shaping and modeling. And shaping and modeling are also theories of learning derived from the above principles. In shaping, we involve the rewarding closer and closer approximately of the want behavior until the correct behavior is achieved. An example of this is when a child learning to write starts with the writing on a paper with straight line and it's rewarded with a star for doing so. Then he then learns to write, starts with writing on a paper with straight line on a plain paper. Or a medical student who starts to learn stitching of wounds, makes mistakes and then attain perfection by shaping. So shaping में basically आप एक behavior को shape करते हैं. Like जैसे हम बच्चों को blank paper पर लिखाना सिखाएं, उसके लिए हम शेप वाइज जैसे उसकी हम लाइंस पहले लगा के उसको देंगे, उसको स्टार देंगे, देन हम उसको कहेंगे बगैर लाइन के वो लिखे, देन आप इस तरह ऐड करते जाएंगे, तो जो डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर हमारा होता है उसको हम शेप करते हैं इसमें. सो व्हाट इज मॉडलिंग? इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन लर्निंग. दिस इज व्हाट अकर्स व्हेन अ स्टूडेंट स्टार्ट्स टॉक ड्रेस एंड बिहेव्स इन अ मैनर सिमिलर टू दैट ऑफ एन इंस्पायरिंग टीचर. When someone gets a haircut to look same as her favorite film star, or a medical student decides to be a surgeon after doing a rotation with an excellent surgical specialist. So, modeling is when you see the inspiring person and you change your behaviors and you want to look like that person. So, you change up apne andar rahte ho, that is according to the modeling. So, this is all about types of the learning we discussed today, and if you like the lecture then please like and subscribe the channel, and also if you have any question you can write down into the comments box. Take care. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.